Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping you with how to represent fractions on a number line. Okay, so it's a very easy thing to do if you know the concept. Okay, so I'll suggest you to watch the video till very end so that if you missed some of the concept in the first problem, you can get that in the second problem. Okay, so let's start with it. So in the first problem we have got four different numbers, out of which three are fractions and one is just a natural number. Okay, so how we can plot these fractions on a number line? Okay, so let's start with the first fraction, that is your 1/2. So in the case of 1/2, we all know 1/2 is basically half of 1. If you don't know, then it is just like this. If you do the addition of 1/2 plus 1/2, it will give you 2/2, that will ultimately give you as 1. So with this also we can say that 1/2 is half of 1, right? And this we generally know also. So what we'll do is we'll mark 1 somewhere over here, okay, 1, and in between of that or just at the half of that we'll mark as 1/2. So we are done with the 1/2. Next comes is 3/4. Right, now what is 3/4? That means if we consider four parts, then on the third one it will lie, right? So let's consider four parts first: first, second, third, fourth. So we have four different parts, right? First, second, third, fourth, we have four parts, right? And we have to place this fraction as at the third one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, four parts, out of which we have to place it on the third, that is 1, 2, 3, right? So it will come over here, that is 3/4. Okay, I hope you got this. See, 3/4 means if you consider four different parts, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, you have to place it on the 3, that is 1, 2, 3. So there we placed. Okay, got it. Next is 1. So 1 is already placed, right? It was not at all tough. The tougher part is this 1/4. Okay, so with this whole we can get that thing that it is crossing the value of 1, so it is more than 1. So we'll mark 2 over here for marking it. Okay, now we need to see 1/4. Okay, so 1/4 is basically the 25% or 1/4 part of 1. If you don't know, you can add 1/4 upon plus 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4, you'll get it as 4/4, which will give you answer as 1. So we can say that if we you can see it like this also, if you consider four different parts on the number line, that is 1, 2, 3, and 4, okay, so it will come on the first part of that, that is over here, okay. And because it is after 1, we can write it like this, 1/4. Okay, so this is how we can place the fractions. If you are not clear with the concept, we are going with the second question or the second problem. Hopefully you will get this thing with that. Okay, so let's go ahead with the second problem. So in the second problem, we have got three different fractions: 1/3, 2/3, and 5/3. Okay, so let's start with the first one, that is your 1/3. So 1/3, how we'll calculate now? First, let's mark 1 over here, all right, for reference. Now 1/3 is basically your 33%, but how we'll know? So what we'll do is 1/3 into 100 we'll do. You'll get the answer as 33%. Okay, or in other words, or in other terms, if you add 1/3 plus 1/3 plus 1/3, you'll get answer as 1. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to divide them in three different parts, that is 1, 2, 3, just like we did previously. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and we'll place it on the first part, that is your 1/3. So we are done with this. Now the second one is there, that is 2/3. Okay, so 2/3 is quite easy. what you need to do is you need to consider three parts, 1, 2, 3, and you need to place it on the second one, 1, 2 over here. So this is also easy. Now if you see the fifth one, directly seeing it you might get confused that how to plot it, right? But if you see it nicely, the same technique you can use. Okay, yeah, first what we can do is we can turn it into a mixed fraction so that things become more clear to you. We can plot it directly also, but this will be a better thing for you. Okay, so what we get it as, this will be a 1, 2 by 3. Now things become much clearer for you. Okay, like this also it's all right, like this also is all right. Okay, so what it is saying is, if you're considering three part, you'll plot it on the fifth one. So right now we are considering 1, 2, 3 part. We need to plot it on the fifth position. So fifth position will obviously fall after third one, right? So we'll mark over here 1, 2, and we'll plot it over here 5 by 3. I know you must have got confused. That's why I did this mixed fraction thing. Okay, so in the mixed fraction, this is your whole, that is 1. So we are crossing 1, that we are sure. And after that, we have to plot it on 2 by 3. That is, if we consider 3 parts after this, then we have to plot it on the second part, that is over here. So either you calculate it through the mixed fraction thing or like directly, it's your wish, whichever thing looks easy for you. Okay, so this was all how you can represent fraction on a number line. So if you like the video, please hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.